Old man, how is it that you hear these things?
Young man, how is it that you do not?
So hello, my young Padawans. These lessons are going to be both humorous and serious. And some of it was going to be rather zen, to be perfectly honest. For example, when I have occasionally been asked, how long does it take to become a Fandai master? When I'm asked that, I can only give one bit of advice. Only a lifetime, perhaps a little longer. When you really understand what being a Fandai master means, you'll discover I'm totally serious. Only a lifetime, perhaps a little longer. And I may be a Fandai master, but I do know those who rank above me. Believe me, they know. They know. Only a lifetime, perhaps a little longer. So let's get down to lesson one. And it's very, very simple, my young Padawans, or at least in concept. You must unlearn what you have learned. You have been trained from birth, from a lifetime of dark, foreboding, and bleak films and TV show, from music that celebrates horror and violence, and a pop culture everly increasingly obsessed with sex, horror, and violence, to think that the world is a horrible place. But it's not. You have had horrible entertainment for one reason. Hollywood, California. You will never find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy. It is a city where rape and child molestation rule the day and has been since it was first founded. One need only look to history to see that this is true. The people who make your entertainment live in a world of horrors. It's the only life that they know. And if horror is the only life that you know, then horror is the only thing that you can create. So your first task, my young Padawans, is simply this. Unlearn what you have learned by a lifetime of fake horrors, that the world isn't that horrible. Certainly you can find horrors, but unless you're in Hollywood, it's not your everyday life. Instead, my young Padawans, you must look to the world around you. It is utterly trite, but the usual. Try to insulate yourself from the pop culture around you. And I'm not going to suggest something stupid, like turn off all of your tech stuff, because I know that's never going to happen. But the point is, what one of the things, especially online, that you need to remember is that what happens online is almost never reality. At best, it is almost never getting any of the facts right. Just try to remember, please, the online world, your pop culture, it's all a fantasy. Don't take it seriously. Not ever. My late great acting guru, Dr. William Morgan, once said that theater is planned, rehearsed spontaneity. And he was absolutely right. Remember that everything that you're seeing, whether it's video, music, pop culture, etc., has been planned and rehearsed before you saw it. Doesn't matter what it is, reality TV show, a live concert, doesn't matter. All of it, TV, films, pop culture, all of it has been planned and rehearsed before it gets to you. It's not real. It's fantasy by its nature. And the online world is no different. You're looking at me here, right now. I'm in front of a green screen. This is planned and rehearsed. I have written notes that I'm following. All planned and rehearsed. I run through this stuff at least once before I throw it out at you guys, for the most part. It is planned and rehearsed. The people that you see online, that you only ever see online, these are not real people. They're a persona of some kind that someone's trying to push. Look at me, for example. I am pushing this persona. This is not what I dress in real life. This is me pushing a persona. Difference is I just tell you about it. But it's all fantasy. Whenever you listen to move to your music or deal with pop culture, or watch movies or TV, just remind yourself it isn't real. It is fantasy, and it's made by people who know only horror in their lives. You must unlearn what you have learned. And that means forgetting everything that movies and pop culture and your music have told you for your entire life, because they are fantasies. This is an ongoing process, and it may take you years to throw off all the horror to which you've been exposed. But if you want to be a Fandai master, it's necessary to see the world from a different perspective, not from the perspective of complete fantasy. It'll happen. It may take years, but it'll happen. When it does, you'll discover that your life is all the better for the goodness that surrounds you. You must unlearn what you have learned. So remember, always know where your towel is.
Ultimate power in this world has always been one simple thing: the control and manipulation of minds.